We're just going to talk about the entrepreneurial mindset and how graphology can really help us in identifying. Today we have Sudhir Kove, who is not only a graphologist, who is also a logo guru. Let's see about his views on how do you identify, how do you create and manifest this money, and how graphology can really help us. Okay, can you induce this entrepreneurial mindset? Let's say like he has got some quality. We are not talking about starting from scratch. He's got some inkling, intention, and maybe some skill.
Okay. So guys, the question is, can I induce? The answer is no. I can't. The only person who is going to change your life is you and nothing but you. There is nobody else and no one else can induce. But yes, surely we can show you the way. See, just because your life is in rut right now, you are stuck with 9-to-5 jobs or, you know, miserable lives, and somewhere you are struggling in money or relationship or health, you want to change, there's nothing bad about it. But frankly speaking, guys, it's a different game. Entrepreneurship is a different game. A lot of you just imagine yourself to be the to be the person who can be a part of this game, but frankly speaking, it's a lot of hardship and a lot of challenges will be there in front of you, and it's not everybody's game. So if even if you have a weak heart, I would suggest you not to go for it. But if you are willing to die and rise again as an entrepreneur, then yes, we do have a solution for you. We can induce some of the characteristics of entrepreneur in you. If you want to get it induced, we can surely show you the road.
I have an interesting question to ask you. See, is destiny something that is in our control, or destiny is something that is predefined? Because if it is the former, that destiny is in our control, then we can do something about it. But what is your view, and what does graphology say about it?
This is the, you know, famous question of free will against destiny. In other words, you are asking the same, whether it's a free will or it's a destiny. So guys, the thing is like, it's a free will all the time. Even if it's a destiny, you will have to work. You know, unless until you work, nothing works. You might be, you know, putting a lot of belief in God or in your destiny, but who knows, God is having belief in you. So somewhere you are the only person who is going to work, and it's exceptionally in your control all the time. You can change. There is one saying about this as well: the moment you are aware about the destiny, the moment you are aware about the future, it changes. So yeah, you can change the future the way you want.
There is an interesting story of the bumblebee. Bumblebee, the way it is made, it can never fly. According to the physics, it can never fly. But surprisingly, bumblebee flies, drinks the honey.
The only reason it flies because it doesn't know the science.
Fantastic. So my next question is, how long does it take? Say for example, I'm a nobody on the entrepreneurial scene, but I'm definitely interested, thirsting to make a mark and help others, obviously. And I'm also passionate about the area that I want to do. So what would be the kind of time scale, or is this time scale related to the kind of action that I'm going to create?
Yeah.
So that's the next question. Yeah.
So how long does it take? So if I ask you, how much time it will take for you to go to Delhi from the Mumbai?
Depends on what mode of travel I use.
Correct. So in other words, it means that how much efforts you are putting. Are you planning to put the efforts of aeroplane or a train or cycle or walking? To put the kind of efforts aeroplanes takes is a massive efforts, massive action. The moment you put that kind of efforts, it will require approximately 3 to 6 months to change the mindset. Else, nobody is very sure how much time it will take, because again, it is directly proportional to the kind of efforts you are putting.
Fine, fantastic. As you are also an established businessman, I also want to ask you, how is this related to running a business? Say for example, I am definitely interested, I am ready to put in efforts and so on and so forth, but there is a certain level of capital that is needed, there is a certain level of business that needs to run. How do we kind of balance this, my thirst, my interest in becoming an entrepreneur, and ensuring that the business runs at least on its own in the beginning?
That's a great question. Sometime back, even on LinkedIn, I got a similar kind of question wherein one person was asking that I want to start a successful startup. So the thing is, guys, you cannot have a successful startup. Because the moment you want a successful startup to start, before that you will have to go a lot of unsuccess, a lot of failures, and that is the only way to through which you will know that what exactly clicks and what real are you. And the moment you find what real are you and what kind of value you are bringing to the table, then only you will get the money, then only you will be able to do something in this world. So knowing one thing is knowing, doing one thing is doing. So unless until you do, nobody can guarantee whether you will be successful or not. But one thing which I will be able to make sure with you, that what is the mindset which is required for anybody's success? See, money, manpower, environment, these all are myths. You can manifest whatever you want, the way you want, in any given condition, as long as you have the faith and right kind of mindset to approach towards to do that particular thing. So what we require is mindset. Are you having entrepreneurial mindset? In the sense, can you take massive actions? Can you take initiative? Can you take a risk? Do you have high self-esteem, whether you are focused about yourself and you don't give a shit about what others are speaking about you? That is the entrepreneur mindset. If you are ready with this kind of mindset, nothing can move you. And even if you have lots and lots of failures in front of you, then also you will go into market again, and you will say one more round, and that is the thing which will make you successful.
This is, I'm reminded of Marwari community. What I heard in Marwari community is they allow setup, give funding and everything else. So they set up maybe even a small shop. Let's imagine that it is not successful. They'll again fund him. They'll fund him even the third time. Only when the third time the guy is not able to come up, then they'll say like, okay, you are no good. So they give them three chances. The question I have is, let's say like we find out the quality of the person, what skills he has got, or maybe the tendency, you would say. It will be easy if somebody is able to mentor. Do you give that services also? It will be a great combination when you identify and the guy is going and you say like mindset. So it's not simple to match up to the kind of mindset that is like overall consistently we can keep it up. So there is always a need for somebody who is capable, who has done this. Preferably we call them as a mentor.
Yeah.
So do you have any plans to help them that area?
In fact, we are actually mentoring a few guys when we give a scientific logo to change the business. We do assist with them in terms of recruitment as well, what kind of employees they should be hiring. Then their own mindset change as well. We help them to house few habits because of which it's easy for them to get to the mindset of entrepreneur, and sales, recruitment, delegation, all those areas we do help them to incorporate in their organization.
I heard from one of your clients that he had certain manifestations and eventually when he asked you to explain, but you had planned it in mind,
yeah,
even before. So how did that come about?
So that is something interesting, you know. People tend to ask me questions upfront that what exactly how are you doing with our logo. So at that time we don't tell them anything, and we generally keep that secret, and we tell them that give me 6 months, because in these 6 months your mindset will automatically change. So we don't have to explain you anything, because your mind is reading the symbol, your subconscious mind is getting influenced by it, and it will manifest on its own. But after 6 months, we do go and make them aware about what exactly we have done with the logo. So this client happens to ask me that what exactly you have done, and I explain him that this is what we had planned for you, and this is what we have done with your logo. So he said that this actually is starting to happen in his organization. So we had a plan for his there was no follow-up with the quotations they were sending. So we centralized the thing, we gave them the focus. Then somehow he was too dependent, his organization was too dependent on him. So what we did is we made him independent, in the sense his organization is independent from him now. So now it's kind of everything is delegated and he's free. He doesn't have much work to do in the organization. And then also we gave him something because of which their losses are reduced, because everything was uncoordinated at that time. So a lot of coordination has happened in his organization. So these three things which we have given to him: focus, coordinated planning, and delegation, high level of delegation.
I've been noticing you and observing you for the last maybe 1.5 years, I would say. I also noticed a tremendous change in terms of mindset, in terms of the way you approach things. What are the things that you did, including using graphology plus additional stuff,
yeah,
to change your mindset?
So if I can share my story.
Go ahead.
Yeah, so basically I am from Nagpur region. For first few years of mine, we were in Bhandara district. So my mother and father both were construction workers. My father used to be a assistant for that road roller, and one day the road roller guy, driver, was not there. So people asked, can you drive it? So he said, yes, I can. So that is how his journey started. He got the job of first that, and then tractor, then he got into jeeps and then trucks. This is how he got up into it.
Wow.
And yeah, so one of the engineer who was involved with the construction, he saw the way my dad was passionate about his work and dedicated about the work. So he gave him the job as a full-time employee of irrigation department, and there onwards our life started changing, because the money flow was consistent afterward. It was not much, but it was good enough to survive, at least we had something to fill in our stomach. So that is the journey, that is how we started. So coming from that background, then we went to Gadchiroli, where the entire area is in Naxalites area. So then again there was not much of education was there, no English, and a lot of challenges were already there in my family, because nobody is educated enough. Even my elder brother, he is a 10th fail for at least 3-4 times before he got copied and passed by somewhere by doing the cheatings and all. So that kind of educational background I had, and I wanted to change, because see, my journey started from I guess from 5th or 6th standard onwards, because I used to read a lot. I was not allowed to play outdoors because my brother was not doing well in the education, so my father wanted me to be good in my own education. So there were strict rules about me not going to the...
So your brother helped you that way.
In fact, when I asked my father that how come you had all the money to teach me, in spite of you having such a small salary. So what he told me that he started saving the money for the education for my brother. And that all money I used afterwards. Because he never went for higher studies. So that was an interesting story he told me. So he always had money for my education. Whatever the amount is, he was ready with the
money. Fantastic.
So, and he only encouraged me to go for this reading libraries and having a library at my house wherein people will come drop their books and I will read, and those kind of things he did a lot. So I used to read a lot in my early school days. I never used to go out and play. And that was one of the area which I still regret. If I would have played a lot, I would have been much smarter. Okay. Because sports makes you much, much smarter, which Street smartness is something which you get with the sports. So that was one of the reasons wherein I was reading a lot, and in those readings I came to know about something called as Vyaktimatva Vikas, or what do you say is the personal development. So I used to read blogs, I used to read newspaper articles and books, and there onwards I started developing myself without knowing that, because I wanted to be a hero which of the book which I was reading. So I then started my own gym, in the sense I went to gym and I started doing exercises to build a kind of personality a hero had. So even if you look towards me now, with the kind of physique I have got, it's like a hero only, because I have been influenced so much by the books, hero, fictitious character of hero. So that is how I was motivated to do, motivated to have good personality. And then when I came to Mumbai, I came to know about that I am no good in comparison with other people, because other people were far, far ahead to me. So again, I had to go in hibernation, work on myself. I studied a lot about how I can be a better speaker with English. So I started reading, listening and watching English, and there, after 3 years, I came out of hibernation, started talking to a lot of people. Mm-hmm. Before that, it was difficult for me to have a single conversation as well in my college days. So that was it. And then in 2006, see, during all this era, I was always alone, aloof, because that is how my father trained me, that is how my background was. Always alone, reading books, mm-hmm. always alone, aloof, doing something. And there was no freedom of expression. Even my own brother has a lot of grudge towards me, because everything which was supposed to be good was in my way and not in his way. You know, I was being given permission to buy anything, do anything, watch anything, and he was not, because I was good with the studies, and that is how my father used to reward me. And he always had that grudge that Sudhir is getting everything and I'm getting not. So no siblings, no friends. Again in college days, I was again alone. So somewhere, even though I was intelligent in my own way, because I used to solve unique riddles, unique problems which nobody was able to do in my school and college days both, I was alone. So somewhere I felt that, yeah, Sudhir, this is not working, you know. You are not able to make friends, you are not able to go and speak in public. You get the easy public responsibility, but you are not able to perform that responsibility in a good way. So there is something missing, because of which you are not able to form relationship. So it was troubling for me, and that is one area where when I went to learn graphology in 2006, it started. I came to know about my shortcomings that these are the areas wherein I am not being able to do good, or this is the area where if this is lacking, you will not be able to do good with the relationship or performance or any other area for that matter. So with this revelation which I had with the graphology, I fell in love with graphology. I learned more about graphology and I started changing myself from 2006. So
I want to interrupt at this place. If you are watching, even if you are from Gachiroli or anywhere else, you got a choice. You can come out easily. Maybe you have to make some efforts. You can read. Look at his life. So irrespective of wherever he was, he made use of all the books that are available. He made use of the limited resources which are available coming his way. All he had to show was interest in furthering, progressing. Continue.
Great, thank you. So in 2006, then I came to know about other stuff which also help you to change, like affirmations. Meditation is something which I used to do from the childhood. The reason being, the comic series you might be knowing, Nagaraj and Dhruv and all those things. Mm-hmm. So they used to, whenever they used to have a problem, they used to sit, meditate, and their problem used to solve. So I even thought that similar thing can happen to me. So even I used to, whenever I used to have a problem, I used to sit, just close my eyes, concentrate on the third eye, and you know, that is how I developed a lot of powers which I think a lot of other people don't have, in the sense I come to know what other person is feeling all the time, you know, what kind of emotions is going through. So that came with the stillness in the mind, I guess. Then meditation was there, visualization, affirmation, and imagination is something which is similar to the visualization but in a futuristic way. So there in 2006 I got one book. The book name was The Science of Getting Rich, and that book influenced me a lot. What is the crux of that book is, whatever you are, right now, it can change if you are willing to imagine and live the change.
Mm.
It's a very profound statement. If you are willing to imagine and live the change is inevitable. Mm. So with that, I was doing a job of software engineer in the HSBC GLT, Kalyaninagar.
Wow. You also have a software background.
Yeah. So I used to stand, our building was near IBM Daksh. So I used to stand and I used to look out from the window and I used to feel like, can I be so big one day that this whatever I see in front of my eyes, in front of my eyes should be owned by me. That was kind of vision. I became uncomfortable with the kind of job I was doing. I said, this is not it. If I want to make it so big, I will have to go in the market, learn something which other people are not willing to or able to, and become an emperor of my own empire, wherein whatever there is in front of my eyes will be mine. So with that vision, I left the job.
Fantastic. Now he is fulfilling on the vision. Ideally, the more you serve others, the more you get benefited. The people basically like give you their money so that you are filling up a most valuable need of the people. So serving is not focused on money. Serving is based on what you are passionate about, what value you can deliver. And he has been creating tremendous value. He has also written a book. So why I'm asking all these questions is to induce, to create that this kind of future, great future, is yours and mine if only we take some few baby steps towards it. And we got mentors. You can talk to him or you can talk to other mentors, you can read books, and then you can elevate yourself. And graphology is once again is a very powerful tool, and here I have an expert who mixes not only just graphology, he also mixes sacred geometry, the way things are placed, maybe feng shui you can call. You can elaborate on that.
Yeah, generally what he was talking about is the scientific logo design which we do. It involves four sciences predominantly: graphology, vastu shastra, sacred geometry and color theory. So we have been able to bring tremendous changes to a lot of organization with that kind of thing. And when I used to look outside the window and used to think that whatever I see should be mine, not in terms of the materialistic way, but in terms of the mind and heart and emotional way, when I should be able to influence those many people that I will be in their heart, and everything what they want will be nothing but mine, just because I have created their lives the way they wanted.
Yeah, with that, I would appreciate the way you shared and wish you all the best in your future journey. And we want to see you as a great graphologist, logo guru, and serve millions of people. Thank you.
Thank you very much, Ganesh, for taking the interview.